Hello everyone, good evening and welcome to the 28th episode of ICPA Clinical Series. And as you all know, the theme of ICPA Clinical Series is each episode one clinical challenge. And every time we take special efforts to identify those topics which our audiences love and the kind of clinical challenges they want to overcome in their practice. So just like every episode, this time also we did a lot of groundwork to identify a good speaker who can talk on a very relevant topic that is very relevant to today's times. And we zeroed in on a digital smile design and we finalized Dr. Sanyogita Kshar, who is a digital smile designer. Dr. Sanyogita did her BDS from SPDC Wardha Dental College. She is extensively trained in digital smile design, DSD, by Dr. Christian Coachman. She has more than 10 years of experience in digital smile designing with focus on harnessing the full potential of various digital tools available for smile designing. Not only digital smile design, Dr. Sanyogita Kshar has gained vast experience by being a part of the team involved in treating TMJ disorders and full mouth rehabilitation. So welcome, Dr. Sanyogita. It's a great pleasure to have you.
Thank you so much.
Even I am looking for this show as a student to know how you have simplified the use of various digital tools. And there is so much to learn from you because I have heard about your excellent treatment planning and execution. And the show is all yours.
Thank you so much. Have we started with the presentation?
Yes.
Thank you, sir. So the topic for the day is use of digital tools for simplified smile design workflow. Please be attentive throughout the presentation. You might have some clinical tips where you will be able to use it from tomorrow as well. So first of all, I would like to thank ICPA and Dr. Rajiv, sir, for this opportunity. It is a great opportunity and I am very thankful, grateful from my heart. I was trained on digital smile designing by Dr. Coachman in 2012, and 2015 when he again came for the world tour, I again went for Dr. Florin Koffer in Hyderabad and in Mumbai. I'm an accredited member of IAACD. I gave exams for 3 years, passed, failed, and then I got that accreditation. I got paper presentation award at IAACD, silver award in 2019-2021. I've done poster presentation as well. And this is sweet. It is the Aesthetic Practice of the Year award in 2022 and 23, the Indian Dental Diva Awards. My practice, it's here at Mumbai, Bhaikala. Here, this is a specialized center, you can see. It is just for DSD, TMJ, FMR, and dental implants. Here I have my practice with Dr. Avinash Shah, who is a TMJ specialist and specializes in FMR as well. Here in this center, we have two dental chair and we exclusively do implants, TMJ and DSD here. For rest of the other treatments, we have our old clinic, which is just two blocks away. Here also we have three dental chairs. So let us go to the topic of smile designing. Now, what is smile designing? Smile designing, it's a cosmetic dental procedure to improve the person's smile. It can be done with normal whitening, overall or veneers, some orthodontics, some gum reshaping, and it has to be tailor-made according to it. Now, in all these years, dentistry before 15 years was more about removing the tooth, putting RPDs, FPDs. Why smile designing? It was due to the advent of mobile phones and selfies. People are getting conscious about their smile, about their teeth position, and about every other thing. So now why digital smile designing and other things? Before 10-15 years, when we used to go to lectures of big dentists, so used to see smiles of models, the before after cases. Then after the presentation, we used to run to them and ask them, sir, yeah, aapne kaise kiya? How did you do this? So they used to say, I have an experience of 10-15 years. It takes time. You'll have to do some courses. You'll have to go abroad and do it. So I always thought ki it was not in my forte. Or ye mere saath abhi nahi hoga. Maybe after 10-15 years, I will be able to do this. So So what is a smile design also? A smile design is a dental procedure by which artistically creates straight. So this is the smile definition.
Dr. Sanyogita, your connection is lost. You are disconnected. There is a small technical problem, I think. Dr. Sanyogita has lost her connection. We are just waiting for her to reconnect. So please bear with us. Thank you. Sorry for the inconvenience. Please bear with us. For those who have just joined in, I want to give you an update that there is a connection problem because of which Dr. Sanyogita has lost her connection. Just wait for a few minutes till she reconnects and starts with her presentation. It may take a few more minutes, that's it. Good evening, everyone. I'm trying to contact the speaker. We had started with the lecture, but there is a small technical problem because of which the presentation has got disconnected. The speaker is trying to reconnect, so it may take a few more minutes. Please bear with us. Thank you for your patience. Hello?
I don't know. Maybe the internet went off.
Now you are back. So please reshare your presentation.
Yes, sir.
You had covered till the
clinic showing
page. We had just started defining the digital smile design process.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, you can start with this.
Yes. Are we live?
Yeah, very much. Your slide is visible. You are also visible.
Okay. So, sorry for the glitch. I never knew that internet went off or I was just disconnected. So I will start this again. What is smile designing? So smile designing, it's a cosmetic dental procedure for improving a patient's smile through various procedures and treatments. It helps in enhancing the appearance by the teeth, gums, and overall facial aesthetics. It can involve procedures like teeth whitening, veneers, crowns, bioorthodontics, or gum reshaping. What is a smile design? A smile design, it's a dental procedure which, this is a definition according to Google, it artistically creates straighter, whiter, beautiful, natural looking smiles. But I just defer to it. A straighter, whiter teeth will always not look good in every patient. You have to do some variation, which you can play later once you go into that process. So before 10, 15 years, we used to go to all speakers. We used to see speakers presenting their cases of smile designing of various models and other personalities, and we used to run after them and say, sir, please teach us, how did you do this, how is this before and after, how did you achieve this result? They used to say ki, okay, this we got an experience of 10-15 years in doing so, it will be done as you go further in the process, and so on. So I always thought ki, okay, I won't be able to do this as of now, maybe after 10-15 years, yes. But when DSD came into picture, it changed my perspective towards thinking that it is considered as an asset, smile designing considered as an asset for the fortunate few. It can be done by all. It can be done by me, it can be done by you, it can be done by any new dentist also, by digital smile designing principle and applying it in your day-to-day practice. It is one earth, one family, and one future. So what is digital smile designing? Digital smile designing is a multi-use conceptual tool that can strengthen the diagnostic vision, improve communication, and enhance the predictability through treatment planning. One second. I awaaz karo na ko, please. Why was the concept developed? Now, concept was developed because when a patient comes to a dental clinic with a chipped tooth or a gap in between the teeth. Now, what happens is he says, doctor, this is my problem. What can we do? The dentist removes his old cases and shows it to them, how he can close the gap, what all he can do with it. Now, the patient sees that and says, okay, we can go ahead. Let's go and start the treatment. We have different visions in our mind. Now what happens is when the dentist starts with the treatment, she does the preparations of the teeth, and then I'm sorry for all the interruptions. So the dentist starts with the treatment, he does the preparation of tooth, takes the impressions, send it to the lab for the veneers or the final prosthesis, crowns, whichever needs to become. What the dentist has in mind? A dentist has in mind a Sonali Bendre type of smile where the line angles are very smooth, the tooth shape is round, and so on. But the technician who is making the prosthesis doesn't have any relationship with the patient. He doesn't know whether it is a male or a female. He will make nice line angles on the prepared cast. He will give teeth like Mallika Sheravat, make teeth like Mallika Sheravat. But what does the patient want? What does the patient want? The patient will always desire a Madhuri Dixit smile, which now we all three, the dentist, the patient, and the technician, all three are in different mindset at different times. So So what happens is nobody knows what the problem came after the final processes come, and nobody even takes up the blame. So therefore, to bridge the communication gap between the dentist, technician and the patient, the concept was developed by Dr. Christian Coachman and brought in India by Dr. Rajiv Verma sir, whom I'm very thankful to. Where can it be applied? It can be applied in all additive cases, crown bridge, veneer fragments, full mouth rehabilitation, bruxism cases. We use it a lot in bruxism cases, crown lengthening procedures, complete dentures, orthodontia cases, implant placement, prosthesis planning, but just cannot be applied in prognathic teeth, which are front in placed in front. So what are the steps in it? Steps is first is planning, then a mock-up or a wax-up, and then a test drive. So we will be emphasizing more on test drives and the planning part. Let's go. Planning, which is the most important part in the procedure of doing a smile designing. So how do we start with this? We start with taking photos. Now, which photos? Photos is a first, is a non-smiling photos to see the lip support. A normal smiling photo where you can just see how much teeth are displayed. A big smile to see the buccal corridors. If they need you need to touch them. Then the other are the side views, the 3/4, where you can see both the sides profile. Then 12 o'clock position from the front. Now this is what I like to do it from front, but people normally do it from the back. Like they ask the patient to tilt their head and then take a photograph from up to see the buccal corridor. Now here you can see this beautiful lady has one tooth buccal, one tooth palatal, again buccal, again palatal. Now she gets to choose where she wants her final smile to be, more retroclined or more buccally placed. Now this young boy has a cant in his teeth, which we cannot identify in a 2D or a front image. Then you take intraoral views, retracted open mouth, retracted closed mouth, and the left and right side. Then on the occlusal plane views, last tooth also has to be seen. Upper and lower incisors with contrasters, the 6 teeth, and 1:1 view with 2 teeth. These are for aesthetic cases and for your accreditation processes as well. Use your scale diligently every time in clinic. Have 10-15 scale lying around. Why? You have to measure the length of the teeth and the width of the teeth. Now, this is very crucial when you're designing a smile, because what happens is patient will always say, that lambe ho gaye, that chote ho gaye, that ye ho gaye. So once you take an approval for a length and width, you just stick to it and show it to the patient every time. Before treatment, during treatment, with trial, test drives, this trial, and the final as well. Then views for the guidances, anterior guidance, canine guidances on both sides. And a video of the patient, speaking video, where you ask them to speak S, F, and all the other sounds. Now comes the planning part. Now the extra oral records, whatever you have taken, have to be planned well. Now, how it is planned? It's a short video I have taken from YouTube. We'll just go run through it and I will help you in what it is said. The extra oral markings, the midline, the interpupillary line, the smile line. Now you can see there are just tools on PowerPoint which are being used. It is just PowerPoint. We just need to use it step by step. Now it is going to the smile, the extra oral, all that parameters will come to the intra oral, the smile line, the interdental area, the zenith, the scale. It's a digital ruler now. Once you have decided where your smile line has come, it's an 85% triangle. Now the shape of the tooth. Now it is decided and it is flipped. Now how it is flipped? There is on the right hand side, there is a shape format option on your PowerPoint. You use that flip vertically. Sorry, horizontally, I'm sorry. And then you put it on the other side. So you have smiles, which are left and right side, are symmetrical and easy. Easy to use. Modify. You can do variations in these, but this for starters, this is good enough. If you need to touch your files, please plan that as well. Now, if you're finding this a difficult or impossible, please, my friends, it is just PowerPoint tool. We just need to use it in a systematic approach. If you're still finding it difficult, take a printout. Take a printout of your photos, extraoral, intraoral, and try drawing lines on it. The midlines, start with the midlines, start with the interpupillary lines, see the canting in the photographs, see the cants in the intraoral. For lab communication, you need to give a one-pager where they will do their wax up, where they can just keep it in front of them and do a wax up. Otherwise, you would say, okay, let me, I don't want to do this. I will start reading. And then I'll eventually learn smile designing. So there are different books on it. It is you can just read with Dr. Ronald, Dr. Gallip, Dr. Mark. Then you can do courses where you can get together 4-5 points and go ahead. So what does these books tell? These books tells us about the various method, a tooth indicator, scale by dense ply, a divider, a paleodent waxing guide. So it just increases the inventory of your clinic. And at the time of actual doing the work, you won't find anything. It is not in place. So we tend to skip steps. So what happens is the end results are also affected. Now, if you start reading a book by Dr. Gurel, you have these many chapters in it. If you go for the midline, just for the midline, there are 2 pages on it. We get tired of reading sometimes because it's not relevant at that time. But in DSD, what you can do is in the patient's face, just on a PowerPoint, take one vertical, horizontal line, put it in the interpupillary region, one vertical line, which goes through the facial midline and the dental midline. Now you can exactly see there is a discrepancy here in the midline. So it is not much visible because 4 mm gap in between the teeth from the deviation from the midline, it's acceptable. If there is a cant in the midline, yes, it will be seen. It will be visible to the naked eye, but 4 mm here and there, it won't be visible. So this is the smile frame. This is the smile frame, which is sent to the lab, where he comes to know all these points which are there in the book. So it just saves your time and effort in reading, understanding, implementing, and going after the lab person. What does a technician get from us? The midline, where it needs to be placed, the smile line, the golden proportion ruler. Golden proportion we hear, 70 by 80, 60, whatever it is. We just cannot apply it physically or by talking to a technician. Then taking the teeth shape, selecting the teeth shape according to visagism. Visagism is a concept by which we select the shape as per the personality of the patient. Like, why now? Now, if Amir Khan comes to you for designing his smile when he's in Three Idiots, and Amir Khan comes to you for designing a smile where he's in Gajini, there are 2 different personalities. You cannot give the same set of teeth to both of them. It has to be according to his internal personality as well. And we can ask also, what type of, how do you want to be portrayed to people? So accordingly, we can change the shape of the teeth as well. Then for the symmetry and balance, flip, like I told before. Then the incisor lens, where and how much it needs to be increased, the gingival levels, the zenith points, and the teeth axis. Changing the teeth axis also makes a lot of difference in the smile. The incisal embrasures. Incisal embrasures, if it is a small ear, it needs to widen as they go at the back. Then lines to be transferred on the cast. I am ashamed to show this, but I need to show this because it shows how it has changed us as me as a clinician and improved. This is a case we had done in 2005. It was a full mouth rehab. She wanted some front anterior teeth. Now what we did, we kept the lateral as same as the position it was. We didn't care about how she looked. She was happy. We took her happy. But now I come to know what could have been done better by increasing the length, increasing the shape, better line angles maybe. Then we got better after some years for the prosthesis. There was no space. So we did a braces for him. But we didn't care about the pink ear. And as the as he was more confident, the lip line went up. And this was shown. Then we again upgraded to veneers. This patient had broken fillings. This was composite. We changed it to veneers. Now the line angles are very prominent here. But the patient is a female patient. Because the same, we just did the preps, sent it to the lab. They sent me the final veneers. Now, what DSD has done to our practice in our treatment planning? So this case here was done in 2007, where there were gap with interdental areas posterior to 2-2 region. My technician said, I can close just this gap here and not this gap. We said, okay, you are God. Please do good work, but give me a good work. Said, okay, fine. And he delivered this prosthesis to us, which we fitted it well. In 2014, where we had a better control on our treatment planning, we got a case with 3 gaps here. See, beautifully closed here. You cannot even see that there was a gap there. It's a full mouth rehab case. How we did it? Photographs. Planning. After the wax up, again we did up. We put a smile frame there. Asked them to add some wax here. Then again checked whether a length and height is proper, whether it is 8x10 or no. And this was the final prosthesis in his mouth. And see this, the previous case which was done in 2007. You can see a cant also here, because the technician had no relationship with the patient on how his smile line was and any other thing. And we also didn't guide him well. So DSD has done this to me. This is a case we did immediately after I did my DSD. Patient didn't want to give any photograph as he was ashamed of doing so. He said, "Jo bhi hai, you just do my treatment. I just don't want to give any photograph." So I did some preps and then asked that lab to give me a temporary. So this is a temporary restoration which he gave. Now what he did? Extra teeth, extra money? Would you give that after you learn a procedure? No. We gave him only teeth which were relevant, not extra teeth, but just adjusted the contours. Now see, the focus has shifted from teeth to his eyes, to all the face and not the teeth. Your work should be invisible. That is our main motto. How? Planning. Treatment planning. Now you can see this, so the same case, extra teeth was there in his temporary denture also. And this is his final. It has been 10 years. I see this patient every other day and I seriously feel very proud of it. Ideally, it shouldn't be done this way. You should have placed implants here or done something else, but still it is working well for him now. Now the second step, that is the mock-up or the wax-up. How you do that? You take impressions, normal impression, digital impressions, do your planning. Digital planning or an exocad planning, get it done with the lab, but just sit with them. Okay, then a diagnostic wax up like this or a digital wax up, that's called copy paste dentistry. Now here you can take the shells of teeth, or you can just copy your, like a mother wants teeth like her daughter, we can just copy and paste it there. Wax ups can be conventional wax up like a normal digital CAD-CAM wax up or a skin concept. Skin concept are thin shells where they're preformed shells which are just applied on the teeth to show how it might look. Then steps. Then we move ahead to the next step. That is the test drive. Test drive is so very important in doing or planning the future. Now, what is the test drive? A test drive can also be called as a motivational test drive. It is a concept by which a patient can have a replica of the final restoration mouth over existing teeth in composite bisacrylate material, that is a protemp or laxatemp, even before starting the case. Just mark my words, even before starting the case, call as the test drive. Now, what is a test drive according to Wikipedia? It is driving of a motor vehicle to assess its drivability or roadworthiness. Like if you go to buy a four-wheeler, what happens is, we go and check all the features. Two people might have different opinions as well. Like this lady here who comes to buy a car, will see the comfort of the seat, the interiors of the car, the color of the car. That is most natural way of seeing. The relative here will see how much the the engine has power, how and other features. Here the salesperson here would always bridge the gap between the two and tell what can be given, what is the features, and sets the expectations right. The same happens here in test drive. We here as a dentist communicate between all of them and tell them what can be given. This is the exact length we can give. Lesser length or more length of the teeth will be a problem or will not be a problem. You see how you like it. If you like it, please take it. Otherwise, you don't like it, that's okay, because we have not touched your teeth, right? What is required for a test drive? You require a silicone index of the wax up what we did. Remember, first was the planning, second was the wax up. Now what we did, we took a silicone index of the wax up. And how we do the test drive? Now the bisacrylate or protem is flowed into the silicone index. Now you see, we are just filling the buccal side. The tip is not been pulled up. If we pull up the tip, we get an air bubble inside it. So air bubble, if it's it is transferred buccally, you might have a void buccally. So to avoid that, just don't raise that, pull up that tip. Then it is transferred into the patient's mouth. And even if the bubble comes, you can just fill it with a flowable later on after the test drive. It is transferred into the patient mouth. Excess is removed via blunt instruments or plastic instrument. Now this putty should have had some V-shaped notches. So it flows out in a better way. After this is transferred into the patient's mouth, we take the photos. We take the photos of the patient. Now, if you think this uncle had come only for his front two teeth, overlapping teeth, and we would have given a test drive for the six teeth, he would have got convinced. Like, so you need to give test drive for whatever you think is right and for the patient also. If he gets convinced, it's okay. If he doesn't get convinced, that is also okay. But you have tried. You have tried to give what is best for the person. So we were taking, so this is Mr. Sampson. He stays in the United States of America. Patient since around 10, 12 years. He comes and goes. So once we were taking his phonetics video and his wife entered. She had gone to market. She entered and see her reaction.
I can't believe it. Can you believe it? This is American. Oh my God. I
don't know what to do with this.
This is just marvelous. They're going to put the real stuff up.
This is the stage drive. This is stage drive. Oh. Yes, yes, yes.
But it'll look like this. Oh my God. You want to go?
Sure.
We'll show you in pre and post photograph to you.
She's not interested. She's not interested in pre and post photograph.
I'm going to shut up my life. Looking at you. I'm going to shut up my life.
She went ahead.
Compliments to Dr.
Thank you.
She hugged him. She
hugged him. I'm hugging you because you're so good.
Thank you.
There are tears in his eyes. This is the real emotion. He gets happy to see his wife happy. Now, if the patient gets convinced, you can do preparations through that test drive, or you need to remove this. Now, just a tip here. Who all are using protemp or bisacrylate will know that it doesn't come out so easily. So here you can see there are white things here. It is what? It is Teflon tape. It is just put in areas where it could get stuck. So you just pack that area and then do a test drive so that it doesn't get locked. So tooth preparations through the prep, through the test drive. Why? It will save on the healthy enamel, which is just grinded off because we are thinking of something else. This is before and this is his after. Doesn't they look beautiful? So this is before test drive and this is the final restoration. Now you can see the test drive and the final restorations are exactly the same. Jo dikhaya wahi diya. Jo dikhta hai wahi denge. Uske alawa hum kuch nahi denge. There is nothing we can do. Then during the test drive, you take a video from the side. If you're doing the upper and lower teeth, now why? You need to see how the incisal edges are occluding. If the palatal carving is good or not. If the palatal carving is a problem, then the sound of sh will come as s and s will come as sh. And if M, F is a problem, then you can turn the video towards the front and see F, S, H, the lower lip line and other stuff which needs to be checked. Now, after the test drive, take the lens, take approval, take signature of the patient, and then go ahead. Now, what does it do? It sets the expectations of the patient right on what he can get, what we can provide, and other stuff. The technician who has no relationship with the patient knows exactly what is to be done. Rather than we giving 100 instructions at different other times, he knows exactly what is to be done. The operating dentist is at ease. Why? Because there is no post-cementation conflicts between the patient, the relatives, and the dentist. Occlusion can be checked. Phonetics can be checked. Guidances can be checked beforehand. Hence, a win-win situation for all of them. Here we come to a case where this female came specifically for veneers. That is very rare to occur, but it occurs. Why? Because she had multiple fillings in her front teeth, which used to come out frequently. She used to come to the clinic every 2 months for the filling. Now, why did this filling come out? And why did she have so much of interdental caries in spite of having so much of a good oral hygiene as well? Because she was a patient of TMD or TMJ. Now, what happens is that there is excessive occlusal loading. She had lost anterior guidance as well. So we put her on a splint for some 6 months or so. Now this splint comes with an anterior and with guidances, which have to be reprogrammed every month for maybe 6 months or 8 months till all the symptoms go away. Now we gave her test drives. Okay, we didn't give her one, we gave her two test drives. One with a manual wax up, one with a digital wax up. Now here in the manual wax up, you can see straighter, whiter teeth, like what she had now. And one with the digital wax up, where the shape of the tooth was altered. The angulation of teeth were mismatched. Like this is one, the angulation of this canine is different from the other. Now what happens is, she gets to choose what she wants. Her husband wanted this one, while she wanted this one. This is her pre-op. Her manual wax up, and this is her digital wax up test drive. Intraoral view, where we checked her guidances. Here you can see when her front teeth were touching, all the back teeth were touching. In the manual wax up, all posterior teeth were disoccluding. So our purpose of doing this test drive also solved this. We did the scans. We thanked Dr. Aslam Inamdar for that time. It was around 2017 where he had this, and we did that. Final preps were done. And impressed veneers were made. This was before and after the treatment. Then again, incisal edges were checked. This is smile extraoral before and smile extraoral after. This is her before. This is the test drive and this is the final. Now see, test drive and final are the same as what it is shown. Now here you can see this is her before and after. Now you see her musculature as well. See her lip line, see her position of face, and see here, it is changed. It is due to the splints as well, and plus the confidence of what she got in smile, because we treated her TMDs. She had better angles. Now you would say, doctor is only showing full mouth rehab, old patients, and other stuff. Doesn't she have young patients or film stars or so? Yes, I do have celebrity clients, but this presentation is for people or inspiring you to use digital dentistry or DSD or or tools in your day-to-day life. Here comes my young patient. She is in her late 20s. Problems everywhere. You can see front teeth problem, right side one tooth extra, left side you just cannot see teeth, difficult smile. Here you can see her. Now if you can see the occlusal view, there is no canine here. There is a canine on the left side. And now what to do with such? We wanted to start ortho with her, but then COVID came and she landed up in some role in a web series. So we had to do her designing. Now here, it is not exactly a DSD frame, but it is for, I've removed most of the things out of it just for you to understand better what we did. Gingivectomy, here you can see gingivectomy somewhere here. And we removed the tooth, this tooth, and premolar is made to look like a canine. See, here, premolar made to look like a canine from the outside. Khane wale daat alag, dikhane wale daat alag. Lowers, implants were done because they got more caries during COVID times. And this is my patient. Now, if you can see, she's not smiling much, but she's smiling through her eyes. These are Duchenne lines. This is a good indicator whether the patient likes your smile. Even if verbally they are saying, okay, doctor, it's a very nice thing. You can see this when she smiles. If they smile through their eyes, you have done a great job. Blooming with joy. A better profile. And yes, not of my pictures. She doesn't have a lipstick because there's joke going around where they say DSD people put lipsticks on patient's face and they say they have a good smile. But we do. After that, I asked her to apply lipstick. And then this is her smile, final smile. Then again, a young female, 18-year-old, marriageable age, was going to get married in 15-20 days. Her profile. This is her before and after. Now, what was the problem here? White spots, multiple caries. Again, the smile designing frame. Gingivectomy was required. So what we did, we placed the test drive in her mouth and just move our cautery or blade here. You can clearly see how the gingival reshaping was done here. Test drive was again placed in mouth to show her. Now you can clearly see there were some problems in her smile as well. So the corrections were made at this stage with the help of the patient on what she wants or what she's finding any problem there. And the finals were done. The lowers we had done, we had given her a home bleaching system where she was using it every day. Her profile from the 12 o'clock position. Her before from the sides and after. You can see a visible whiter teeth in the lower arch. And the occlusal view. Now, you would say, okay, we are just showing you cases where we are designing the whole smile. Now, you can see we have touched her buccal surface as well on the 5 region. Because if you can see her here, it looks as if it is just pressed from the side. Therefore, we used it on the 5. If the patient budget is not there, he cannot go beyond 4-5 teeth or 10 teeth. So you can just add composite just to add the bulk. You would say, okay, you're showing only cases where there are smile designing for multiple teeth. Now, this patient came to me. Be saying, doctor, when I smile, I take my selfie from one side, I feel I'm toothless. Yes, it does look toothless, but I have a tooth. It is there. It is blocked out. Now, what will you do? What will you do in such cases? Here, it is a khane wala daat alag, dikhane wala daat alag. We just placed a tooth here. It is a Emax crown. Now, you can see on this cast, it is bonded on the back. A gingivectomy was done here, bonded on this tooth, the central and the lateral, and it is placed here. It is 3 years in his mouth, it is not debonded, it is still there. We were convincing him for an ortho, but he is now reluctant to do this because his problem is solved for the selfies. Again, a patient, a treated anterior, wanted a smile makeover with almost 5-7 teeth, but just 2 veneers in his front teeth to change his smile. Fair enough. What is needed will be given. The old auntie, which we showed before in their photographic protocol, see her before and after, all the side views, another aesthetic views, retracted closed mouth. This was her planning, which was done. See, the shapes are exactly what we had planned. The side views. Now you can see a cross bite here, but the cross bite is corrected here. It happened due to reprogramming. We gave her long-term temporaries, which were adjusted at frequent intervals, and therefore we could achieve this. From the other side, the front view for the guidances and aesthetic view as well. Here you can see how well it is blended. The gingiva is happy. There is no crying of gingiva. Everything seems to be perfect. You can apply your smile designing in your implant patients as well. Here in this patient, edentulous, required implants. We made a denture to see. Now you can see the midline is not perfect. The smile line is not good, which is later on corrected in the final prosthesis. Another case where when again implants was required in anterior region, they were retroclined, extruded, planning was done. These are our implants in front region, and this is his final smile. Now from getting to a retroclined smile to a front smile, it is very difficult because you are just moving that tooth out. So we have to be careful regarding the shape, size and other things. So a test drive also gives this. Again, a lady for implants, this is her final prosthesis in mouth. Replacing a single tooth is the most difficult job. Here is a single implant here. So there are different processes here. You can see one veneer, PFM crown, metal-free crown, again a PFM. But they all seems to look okay. It seems to be okay in her mouth. Now why? Why? Ask this question, why? Because the shape of the prosthesis is perfect. So from every angle, whenever you see her, the light reflects in that way. So it is not visible to a normal person. Yes, maybe to a dentist it will be, but it is not visible because the shape of every prosthesis is the same. Now, for application of DSD in perio, patient complaint was husband called her Bugs Bunny, or the color of tooth was, it was a problem as well. Then gingivectomy was planned, test drive in mouth. And I just move my cautery here. I don't use laser. So we wrote on the tooth how much cautery is required. And we did that. Rechecked if it is proper during the process as well. During the processes. And this was her final smile. We eventually gave her veneers as well. What is the difference between a conventional method and a complete digital workflow? It is these are the points. It is more easy. E-transfer is better. There is a lot of value addition, less time consuming, and many other things. So digital smile designing, it is similar to the transformation from fetching water from rivers to accessing it through taps for convenience. So dentistry has shifted from traditional methods to utilizing digital tools. These tools like digital imaging, CAD/CAM have revolutionized how oral health is addressed, offering efficiency and effectiveness akin to use to getting water from the taps. So why to use digital tools? Sir, can I? No, okay. I won't use this because it's 10:20 already. So these are the points why digital tools needs to be used. It saves on the time and resources. It helps you in patient engagement where the patient is always involved with you in the process. Like I remember when we bought our scanners, first we used to do splints where we used to take 6 hours for one patient. The impressions, the Facebook transfer, the mounting, to then making wax pattern, sending it to the lab and getting. So it is just concise to half an hour procedures. We save on the time, we save on the material, we save on the manual errors which happens, which is completely better will have. So now we would say ki will AI take over dentistry? AI would never take over dentistry because no patient would like to have somebody a robot doing treatment in him when he is awake. So adapt to whatever digital tools you have, from PowerPoints to scanners to CAD/CAM technology, and improvise on your work. Because there are no manual errors, the sooner the better, because you'll have to adapt to it in one day. Digital is no longer a concept of future, it is the present. It is the present. I did it, you too can do it. Why? Because I got access to a proper computer only after my marriage. Then YouTube came in around 2009 and 10. Then smartphones in 2012. This is just recent, 5-10 years, maximum of 10 years what it is. And I would like to thank my family, Dr. Abhinash Shah, who is after me, like very strongly after me. Behind every successful man, there is a woman, but behind every successful woman, there is a team, there is a family who is there. These are a set of parents, my in-laws and my father, mother, who have been together throughout with me. Thank you. And yes, my team as well. Yes, these are all my team who is with me since 10 years. Who are equally mad as we are. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Sanyogita, for that.
Sorry for being overboard. Actually, in between, I just
no, lost. No problem. No problem. Direction. There was a small technical glitch, but you overcame. And thank you for the audience who stayed with us, who did not disconnect. And the number has remained constant throughout the session.
Great.
So I thank each one of them for their patience and support.
Yes,
that was a wonderful lecture. You took it from the right from the definition and the tools you use in your clinic and how your own concepts evolved over a period of time, right from the time you got your basic training done in digital smile design. So let me take you through some of the questions sent by our registered delegates. So the first one is, you have already answered it. Will AI help in digital smile designing?
Yes,
so it will. Said, it will not take over, but it will definitely help. How you can say?
So the Adobe Photoshop is there. DTS Pro is there. There are ExoCAD plannings are there where you can use it for simplifying your smile designing protocols. If you don't want to do it on your own, you can do it on them and show it to the patient on how they can look. But seeing it inside the patient's mouth, it gives a different high to them as well.
Okay. The next question is how to do Facebook digitally.
So Facebook digitally is it is done in ExoCAD where they are planned. They have to preset it according to your articulator which you have in your clinic, and then we can. It is done digitally.
Okay.
It has to be set.
Okay. The next question is, do you recommend any treatment planning software other than the conventional DSD?
DTS Pro. You can try that. Pro. Yes, okay. It is by Dr. Neeraj Roheda.
Yeah.
I am not aware of others.
Yeah. So for those who are asking the question, is there any other planning software? And those who asked how we can show it to the patients, DTS Pro is one of the tools available. And we had Dr. Neeraj Roheda in one of our earlier episodes. You can always go to our YouTube channel, check ICPA Clinical Series. And one of the episodes is by Dr. Neeraj Roheda. And he has the entire session explaining how DTS Pro is to be used clinically.
Perfect.
Any books for beginners who want to understand digital smile workflow?
Okay, so Gallup Gurel, The Art and Science of Porcelain Laminate Veneers. I had shown Dr. Goldstein's book, Dr. Mark's book. This it's good to start.
Gallup Gurel.
Yes.
Next question. use of DSD in periodontology, you have already shown a case.
I've shown. Yes, yeah. I've shown.
Yeah. How we can utilize DSD without incurring lots of investment?
So there is no investment. It is just PowerPoint.
Okay.
It is just PowerPoint available everywhere throughout your Microsoft and keynotes in and a keynote in Apple. Who use Apple?
Great. So for Windows, it is PowerPoint, and for app, for MacBook, you can use Keynote, and it's an already installed software. You can use it, so there is no additional cost.
Yes.
Okay. How often and how frequently you use it for tooth whitening?
Tooth whitening. Are they asking a material? I use opalescence boost.
Available options in bleaching. Okay. I think, I don't know whether he's asking for materials or any software for showing to the patients how much we can
bleaching. No, no. So that is a highly unpredictable procedure. Never, never, ever say ki you will get 4 shades lighter or 7 shades lighter. We never promise that.
Never promise beforehand.
Yes, yes. Okay. And in smile designing also, you under promise and overdo and exceed the expectations.
Okay. There is a question from somebody practicing in a tier 2, tier 3 city. He says, how to start practicing smile designing, especially DSD, in tier 2, tier 3 cities? And what are the procedures suitable for our area, considering the financial constraints the patient has in these cities? My question is, what procedures are suitable to begin in the field of digital smile designing so as to upgrade slowly in all the related procedures?
So first of all, we need to change the mindset. It is never a tier 2, tier 3 city. It is people. We are treating people. We are treating humans. So never think there is a financial constraint. Every area, in fact, every area, aapke mohalle mein, there is a millionaire who would always want a good treatment. People travel from cities. We have patients from every tier 2, tier 3 city who want good treatment. But if you get it available there at your place, why will they travel? Why will they travel to tier 3 cities? You can do it at your own. Now, for if you say financial constraint, now, if you're charging thinking about charges for the veneers, you reduce your profits in some cases, in 1 or 2, 3 cases, and then you can charge more as you proceed and as you get confidence in your treatment. And regarding the use of digital tools, it is simple, it is easy, or you can use help of RSD by Dr. Aslam Inamdar, where he gives the motivational, he will design the smile, he will do the motivational mock-up, give the printed cast, and then you can go ahead and test drive the smile with it. And I showed you one case which we had done with him as well.
Yes. And we had Dr. Aslam Namdar in our
he was there.
Clinical series. He was the second episode. The second episode of clinical series. People can watch it on YouTube, that episode as well. Okay. Next question is, how the number of days has reduced after you started using DSD? And what is the minimum number of days where you can finish a case, considering the workflow that you suggest?
Okay. So initially when we had started, it was WhatsApp. The WhatsApp, we used to go send it to the lab. The WhatsApp used to take around 1 or 2 weeks with the good labs. And then we used to transfer it into the patient's mouth. So it was like a month's procedure. Like after using scanners, the scan immediately goes. The planning is done on the next day. I don't have to visit the lab for breaking my head on them. So it is done digitally in front of me on a team viewer. And the WhatsApp, the digital printed model comes to me almost on the third day. And the case is finished in a week's time.
Great. Great.
Before
any guidelines regarding how we can use digital smile designing for shade match and shade selection?
Shade match, shade selection. So there was one slide where we had taken the shump shade and the front shade. Though for just a tip, while taking the shade, just see your incisor shade tab is just parallel to your front tooth, not on the side or extremely on the other side. it just has to be on parallel to your incisal edge, because the light should fall properly on it. Then you can use gray cards on the side of it for the technician to know better what shade it is. With scanners, they also come with shades, but I would still say it can do it manually.
Okay, great. Last two questions remaining. What are the limitations you want us to know about digital smile design?
You'll have to give time initially, your own time, your busy time to develop it, to put it in your daily practice. It is like if you go and learn implants, right? You take time. You put first implant, then two implants, then you go on sinus lifting and any other things. Like how we started. We started with multiple unit bridges, then veneers, then we started playing around on changing the shapes, size, and the expectations of the patient. So just have to give time initially.
Any case where you cannot use digital smile design?
Prognathic teeth for the test drive.
Okay.
We cannot do a test drive there.
Okay. So last question. Do you recommend the use of digital pre-shaped teeth profiles for smile designing, or prefer customization for each patient? Which software is more user-friendly and easier to perform?
So, yes, customization should be your priority in mind. Preform shape, yes, you can use a triangular teeth for a central and a square shape for the lateral as well. Canines, you can just pump out outside or do inclination, but that is later on in the practice where you know the patient will be okay with that. Or you can show, like I showed you in one case where we gave two test drive for the patient. One was a manual and one with the digital waxer. So they get to choose what they want.
Okay.
And okay, software, I use DSD only, but the other softwares like DTS, RSD, you can use them.
How is your experience with RSD?
It's good. It's good. People find it expensive, but it is just a value addition what you get.
And once you show the test drive and once you show the end result to the patient, it is not difficult for them to visualize their future and accept the treatment plan.
Yes.
Okay. Great. That was great. So that brings us to the end of 28th episode of ICPA Clinical Series. Thank you, Dr. Sanyogita Kshar, for beautifully outlining the workflow of DSD, the way you do in your clinic, and showing the cases. And I wish you all the more luck for your future cases. May you collect more and more celebrity pics, and so that I can call you in one of the future sessions with more time where you can show all your cases. And that brings us to the end of this session. And people who missed this session will get a link in the coming days for the recorded session. You can watch the recorded session on YouTube. And if you are connected with us on our WhatsApp list, you will also receive a 5-point summary of this lecture so that you know what are the salient points, the take-home points. Okay, with that, we'll end this session. We'll soon connect with you all with the new announcement, 29th episode of ICPA Clinical Series, each episode one clinical challenge. So once again, thank you all of you for staying with us. And good night. And good night, Dr. Sanyogita. Thank you for accepting the invitation and joining. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.